Hey guys, we're going to check out the pen tablet called Star G640s from xppen. We're going to check its physical review, features, software functions, and do some tests on Blender, Photoshop, and in an Android phone. So if you're interested, stay tuned and watch the video. Hey, what's up guys, it's Mac here, and we do a lot of tech review videos like this one. So if this is your first time in this channel, consider subscribing. With that said, let's take a look what do we get inside the box of the item we have for today. Obviously, the tablet itself, the battery-free pen, 20 nibs replacement, USB cable, pen clipper, pen sleeve, USB to USB Type-C adapter, USB to micro USB adapter, and some documentations. Now let's check out some physical overview. First, the build of the pen. It is made out of sturdy plastic and it is in the heavy side in terms of pen weight, which what I prefer the most. It has a matte black design on this part and on the tip as well. In between, there is a simple glossy plastic part for a nice aesthetic and a smooth rubber material for your hands to hold on. The pen also has a two fully programmable buttons with a satisfying click in every press. And something worth mentioning is that this pen is battery free, meaning it is a passive pen that works with the tablet without battery. This is becoming more common nowadays, and if you're still using a chargeable pen, I suggest get one of these already. In case you overly use a pen nib, you got 20 more replacement in the package, which is awesome, and that is what we call more than enough. So to remove the pen nib, you need the clipper included in the box. Clip it in this way and pull it. And to place a new one, just simply get a nib and just put it in this way and place it in. Now let's check out the tablet's physical overview. The build is also made out of a very sturdy plastic material with a very unique design on this part and on these sides as well. Except for this one over here, it's a bit round and I do like the contrast. Underneath, there are four rubber feet to keep the tablet in place while drawing. And just in case you're wondering what is this for, its purpose is to hold the pen when not being used. You just have to stick it on the back or wherever you want. It's more like something to hold on the pen whenever you are on the go. So this tablet has 6 fully programmable buttons, and in between those buttons is a single lighting indicator in blue color. More into that later. This is the active drawing area. And just in case you want to know the exact dimensions, just check these captures out. Enough with the physical overview, now let's check out some features. The first thing you need to know about this tablet that it works on Windows, macOS, and Android as well. And yes, you've heard me, this works on your Android phone, and we'll try that out in a bit. So this tablet has 5080 lines per inch, 266 report rate, and 8192 pressure sensitivity. If you're still using less than 8192 level of pressure sensitivity, you are missing a lot, so I suggest get one of these today. Moving on. This tablet also has a 0.01 inch accuracy and 5 to 10 mm reading height. So even though how much you move the pen, unless it is on this height, nothing will happen, which is good. And if you want to know more about its features, just check this out and pause the video. Now let's check out the driver software. So over here, you'll see what xppen is currently plugged in your computer. As for me, we have the G640s. Over here is the current screen mapping, where your tablet will be able to function. You can use monitor 1 or monitor 2. If you want, you can use both, but for now, let's just use monitor 1. You can also switch into different orientation, whether it be 90, 180, or 270 degree. That is also possible, but for me, the default one is just perfect. And one of the coolest part of this software is that you could actually set your own work area on your screen. You could set it to max, you could set it to aspect ratio, or if you feel if the work area is a bit too large for you, you can make it smaller. To do that, simply click this button over here. Then click a specific part on the tablet using the pen. So over here is where you customize your pen buttons. You can turn it to no action, right click, middle click, pen eraser, run a program, or change a function key like macros in the keyboard, but it's only limited in 20 characters. I don't usually change these buttons even in my other pen tablets. I always set the bottom as right click and pen eraser on the top. So let's just keep that on default. Now over here is where you customize the click sensitivity. If you like the pressure sensitivity to start kicking in a soft or hard output, you can actually modify this graph accordingly. And lastly for this window is the cursor sensitivity. It is on absolute mode by default, but you can make it faster or slower by moving this option over here. Now before we check on the Express Kids windows, let me just inform you that the 6 fully programmable buttons has an anti-ghosting feature, meaning you can press multiple keys at the same time and all keys will be registered altogether. Well, this feature is what I've been looking for a very long time now, and I guess xppen nailed it. Good job, guys. Now let's open the Express Keys. This is where you can change the 6 customizable buttons in your tablet. It also has the same function as the barrel button settings for the pen. But what I really love about this is that you could actually link your button settings to a specific software, and it will automatically switch your buttons whenever you change into your active window. For example, I have a different button settings for Blender, and I also have a different one for Photoshop. These buttons will change accordingly whenever I change my active window. This is something that I really appreciate since I constantly switch from software to software whenever I'm designing my 3D models. You might be wondering who should buy this pen tablet. Well, these are for digital artists who are on the go. The pen tablet is actually very light and easy to carry, so you don't need to worry about its weight. Some artists like to go into different environments to envelop themselves with inspiration. And this is where you find the Android compatibility significant, because when you feel inspired, you actually want to start making your own digital arts. Okay, let's just start to set this up for Android. Setting up is very straightforward. First, you need the adapter specifically for your phone. As for me, I'm using the Type-C adapter. Simply plug that adapter on your phone and connect it with your tablet, and you're good to go. It's more like a plug and play kind of setting up. You might also be wondering what app can use this tablet with. Well, basically any app that can detect pen pressure. Like for example, Medibank Pro, Autodesk Sketchbook, ArtRage, or xppen's DecoDraw. There are a lot of apps that you can use this tablet with, but you just have to choose whatever fits you best. Also, something worth mentioning, just make sure that your Android phone is in version 6 and above. So this is how it looks like when you're using this tablet on these apps. Now let's test this tablet using Blender Painting. So I made this model a few months ago for a specific game project that I'm currently working on. For the most parts of the textures and large details, I edited it in Photoshop, but we're going to use Blender Painting for more specific details. Like for instance, the highlights on the head, the dark parts on the eyes, the continuity of the cracks, and the teeth details, and so on. So as this video time-lapse is playing, I'll share my experience with you. So let's begin. Drawing on the surface of this tablet feels like you're drawing on a smooth paper, but it doesn't make much noise, which is nice. I don't really like the paper and pen collision sound since it's a bit annoying for me, more so to those who are around me whenever I use it. Well, it's just a personal opinion, but let me know what you think in the comment section below. Best thing worth mentioning is that you'll definitely feel the accuracy of the tablet in terms of doing small details. Having 8192 levels of pressure sensitivity and 5080 lines per inch in 266 degree portrait plays their part very well. I can't really imagine myself having less number than this. On the other hand, the 6 customizable buttons are very handy, especially when you want to lay back on your seat, place the tablet on your lap while designing. though you need to practice your muscle memory in order to do so. I'm really loving the anti-ghosting feature since you can press this button simultaneously and it'll register all together at the same time. This is very convenient, especially when you move around this model in Blender. If there is no anti-ghosting feature, I probably use my keyboard all the way until I finish editing. As expected from its features, the pressure sensitivity on opacity, airbrush, and pressure size works smoothly in a very accurate transition. Lines are not jagged and no pixelated lines. I really love the accurate details I'm getting while I'm putting some small details on this model. All I'm saying is that this tablet is really great and I really love it. And I guess I'll be switching with this. The G640s as my daily driver. All I can say for now is that this is way better than the other pen tablets I currently have in my office. I'll be stating my reasons why in an upcoming video comparison soon. So make sure you subscribe and click that bell icon to be notified. In conclusion, with 8192 pressure sensitivity, 6 customizable express buttons with anti-ghosting feature that works in multi-operating system, not to mention it supports left and right hand users for only $39.99. You could never go wrong with this pen tablet, and I highly recommend it to any beginner and serious artist out there. If you want to get one of these today, I place a link in the description below. Make sure you check that out. So that's it guys, if you found this video interesting and helpful, make sure you give us a thumbs up and share it. Thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.